Welcome back. We're still talking about the year that was in the political and the judiciary. We have with us our guests, you know them by now, familiar faces. We'll start with you, Mari. Do you see an end to this battle royale? And if so, what can actually soothe the relationships?
Well, the government is open to the dialogue. In fact, there was an offer to the dialogue. To see an end, first of all, hindi naman, this was not embarked by the president just so magkaroon ng giyera. He was on a crusade.
Yes.
He was on. He was trying to fulfill a promise to the people. And along the way, may stumbling block. And it so happened, in this case, the government felt that the court, the Supreme Court, was not impartial on this. No, so.
What did he expect with what he did on his attacks, personal attacks against the Supreme Court Chief Justice, repeated it in a Makati Business Club forum? What did he expect? Did he think that the CJ would budge and just because of shame and being embarrassed?
No, I don't think he would quit. I don't think so. That he was expecting that.
Mm-hmm.
I think yung kay presidente lang naman, if you're the president and people expect you to do certain things, no, people, you promise to the people that, hey, we'll clean the government, we'll clean the bureaucracy, walang korab, etc., etc. And you see na merong problema, meron namang sa tingin ng nag-aaral, nag-a-advise, na meron namang substantial na evidence. Anong gagawin mo? Like, do you keep quiet and do you just say, wala, i-dribble na lang natin to? Siyempre, ipupursue mo yun to send a message. Kasi nga, sa tingin natin na itong 6 years, alam naman natin, would never be enough to really, really change the whole country.
But sa dami nga po
ng mga
supposed charges that the former president will be facing, isa lamang po ang naisampa.
Yes. And
so hindi ba dapat na imahin nila yung paghahanda nila dun sa lahat ng mga kaso para merong silang maisasampa? Because isa lamang ang hinaharap niya ngayon, and this is the electoral sabotage of 2004. Oh. Hindi ba yun ang pinagsisimula nitong parang kulang pa ng bala para maipush yung talagang mga kaso na dapat harapin ng dating Pangulo?
Ang ano naman, I'm sure pinaghahandaan naman lahat yan, Hina. No? But I want to bring siguro the discussion beyond that. I mean, the spirit why the president is doing what he's doing. And it's not just locked in on one person like the former president. We have to see that. Eh. Hindi yan siya nakalock in lang sa isang tao. Passionate siya to bring change to our society. And what he's trying to do is trying to put the right values, the foundation that will outlast his presidency. And if he will give a blind eye and if he will not be very passionate in pursuing what many people perceive as a corrupt practice in the past, how will you send a message to the future? So, kumbaga, when we discuss this what is happening to us, this event now, we should not be locked into just one person, like parang vindictive naman kayo. Hindi. It's a message. It's a message that he's trying to put that the law should work for everybody. And if even, no, like for example, the Supreme Court, I'm not a lawyer, if the Supreme Court harang dyan, sino magtatanong kung impartial ba yung court or hindi? Kunyari, sasabihin na natin, for the sake of discussion, sabihin natin dihado ang tao. Anong gagawin ng isang presidente? Tatahimik ako? Tatahimik ako? Siyempre, I will have to also tell my people, tell the whole nation, hindi ko tututulugan. I'll fight for you.
So yun ang nakikita niyang pamamaraan para ilagay sa ayos.
Hindi kami nag-usap, but ganun yung dating. Sa akin, danun yung dating ng mas maraming tao na parang all of a sudden, people will see na okay to ah. Di ba? Okay to. Like, may pagbabagong mangyayari. Kasi he made a social contract when he ran eh. And he is really determined na i-fulfill yung kanyang social contract.
And sa pamamaraang ganito, sa pagsasalita niya ay nakikita niya na mailalagay sa ayos yung mga pamamaraan ng pagdidesisyon ng mga
hindi,
members ng court
hindi
or mababago?
Naman, hindi naman sa isang speech.
O sila, hindi naman.
Hindi naman sa speech yan. I'm sure meron naman yung usapan, may dialogue naman.
So ang itinatanim niya ay yung mga values sa mga tao.
Itatanim niya sa mga values sa mga tao na...
More than the court.
Beyond the court. Una, hindi sayang na binoto niyo ako. Pangalawa, tinutupad kong sinasabi ko na ayusin natin to. May pagbabagong mangyayari. So, it's not just...
Kung may mangyayaring pagbabago.
Sigurado may mangyayaring pagbabago. Una, let's face it. We have a president that is not corrupt.
Uh-uh.
Diba? I mean, kung titignan talaga natin, He's trying to say na it's possible to be a government public servant, a government employee na hindi tayo on the take.
Mm-hmm.
No? So that possibility is inspiring a lot of people. And we have seen naman the fresh outlook, the yung magandang tingin ng global community on the Philippines. And nakikita natin yan sa rating. I don't think 7 out of 10 Filipino is wrong. I don't think the Filipino is not capable of discerning properly or looking at things and saying, parang okay ito eh. Di ba? I mean, kasi kung majority yan, although this is not a majority game or popularity game, pero if you have 7 out of 10 Filipinos na still trusting the president, ang laking obligasyon and responsibility.
At dito nanggagaling yung lakas ng
dito
Pangulo.
Dito yung nanggagaling yung passion niya and passion. Conviction.
Okay.
When we say lakas, it's not to be used against other, but the conviction I have to continue to do what I think is right for the people.
Attorney Topacio.
Yes.
Options here.
Sabi sa Spider-Man, with great power comes great responsibility.
Spider-Man.
Okay.
Sabihin, the option of the president, if it is at all possible, ano, but miracles still happen, is to have himself educated by his legal eagles on the finer points of constitutional law. Hindi pwedeng what is popular is necessarily right. That is not logical. And now, we respect the mission of the president to effect changes in society. But these changes should be done within the context of the law. He should be reminded that the country is not Hacienda Luisita. He's not the master of the hacienda. And the philosophy is not ang utos ng hari ay hindi nababali. There are other constitutional safeguards. Now, if you experience setbacks in the court, instead of thinking immediately that this court is against me because the majority are appointees of the previous administration, you should stop and think about the kind of setbacks that you're getting. For instance, the Truth Commission. I was not yet involved with any of the Arroyos last year. I was just minding my own business as a lawyer. But immediately, from as an objective observer, I knew that there was something wrong with the executive order that created the Truth Commission, and I said, this is unconstitutional. I was only retained by the Arroyos in October. On August 15, when I saw in the papers that they had created a joint DOJ-COMELEC preliminary investigation committee, I immediately said, there is something wrong with this. You do not fuse an independent constitutional body like the COMELEC with the Department of Justice. So these are matters that he has to be open to. Instead of immediately unleashing the hooting throng or using his popularity like a blunt instrument to hit the heads of the magistrates of the Supreme Court. And this takes judicial statesmanship. I mean, executive statesmanship. You know the reason why the America, the United States of America, is such a strong democracy is its respect to the institution. For instance, just one example. If you recall Bush versus Gore, wherein Al Gore, who was then vice president, was ahead in the popular vote against George W. Bush.
And in Florida, in the
yes, in Florida, it came down the line that the electoral college votes of Florida would decide the contest, and Gore lost in a Supreme Court that was widely perceived to be packed by appointees of the other party. But what did Al Gore say? Did he say, "My fellow Americans"? the U.S. Supreme Court is biased because the appointees are mostly from the other party. Therefore, let us all rise. Let us not respect this. What did he do? When he received the decision of the Supreme Court, he said, I have read the decision of the Supreme Court. I do not agree with it, but I will respect it. And that closed the chapter on that particular thing. No turmoil, no marching in the streets, no angry words. George then went on the phone and congratulated George Bush. That should be the attitude of the president.
Point well taken. Professor Tayao.
There are two points, Tina. No? I agree with Usec here, no? Na merong kwan, gustong sabihin ng presidente, may pinanindigan siya, so he is going to do that. But again, there are so many comments, and I mentioned so many different constitutionalists. And ang unang tanong dito, do you have the right lawyers? Ako naman, I'd like to think, I know some of them personally, and I'd like to think there are so many good lawyers in the government now. But my question is, if and when we think that there are enough lawyers, is there someone or is there some kind of direction that is being followed? Kasi baka may mga, alam mo na, syempre magkakaiba ng opinion yan, no? So there has to be some kind of orchestration that has to be done. I'm not a lawyer, but I'd like to think that the strategy is very important here. Eh?
No, that's if it were a party whip, it was a legal whip.
That's right. That's right. So I have to say this. I have to say this precisely because, you know, sabi nila yung TRO na lang eh, no? Kailangan pa namin ng time, diba? Kasi it's not the executive who's going to prevent you from leaving. Eh. It's supposed to be the court. That's how I understand it. It's very basic. But the point is, bakit hindi pa nafafila ng kaso at that time? Why does it have to be the executive branch that will prevent a person, a former president at that, to leave the country at that particular time? No? So you question the timing. And sabi nila, kulang pa eh. They've been in government for 17 months. And even before, even during the time of former President GMA, there were already investigations. No? So marami ng mga papel yan. No? So, ang tanong ko lang, bakit yung 17 months kulang? Kasi ang dami kong tanong. Before coming here, for example, I should come up with a parallel example. Before Makati to Quezon City, it will take you only an hour. Ngayon ang tagal. Sabay-sabay yung road repairs. Sabi nila, kasi kailangan pang i-disaggregate yung budget. This is their budget now eh. This is not the budget of the previous administration. They submitted the budget last year and this is their budget now. So it should have been their own budget which can easily be implemented. So why is it that it's in the last quarter that you are wanting to expend the most of the budgeted funds? So yun lang ang point. Maraming magagaling and they mean it well, eh, no? Mm-hmm. I know was Secretary about the person and I know of course that they mean it well when they want to do things sparingly and so on. Now, as far as the option is concerned, again, I know that there are so many in government who knows and who believes that there has to be far-reaching reforms. And there are so many pending in Congress. You have to amend the code, you have to come up with the party reform law, and so on. No? And I'm sure also that there are so many close people with the president who knows that there are needed political reforms also. This should be a road that may be, that should be considered by the president. And I hope it is done before the midterm election. Mm-hmm. Pero yun lang, masyadong mahabang proseso kasi. Mm-hmm. So baka gusto nila masyadong wala kasing overnight na proseso dyan eh.
Attorney Tamano.
Yeah, I can't help but agree with Ed, no? Siguro to put a focus, si President Aquino has this massive popularity as was stated by Mari. And I actually believe, I know him a little bit personally, that he is definitely not corrupt and there he's passionate about these reforms that he wants to make. But I think it's a bit misplaced. I think he should use that strong political capital instead of taking issue with the judiciary and use it for the proper reforms. One thing that really keeps struck my mind was the latest survey on self-rated poverty, which is now 50.2%. More than half of Filipinos feel that they're poor. And this is despite a conditional cash transfer program of 21 billion, I think. That's right. I'm not really sure like about about the number. So for me, this issue with the court, I believe it is a distraction. Mm-hmm. If the president truly believes that some members of the court are unfit, then he should impeach them. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, if we continue along this path with this war between the judiciary and the executive, it's such a waste of time and effort. I would want him to use his massive popularity to issue the RH bill, issue the Freedom of Information Act, and to create the necessary reforms on the ground. Because I think at the end of the day, the Filipino people did not elect him to run after those justices, but rather to lift them out of poverty.
Okay, that's not the Tamano perspective. This is Talkback with Tina Palma. Thank you so much. That's all the time we have. Talk to us again next week on Talkback.